Once you've gotten familiar with classes and all the power you gain and the time you save, tags are even more empowering in that they cut out so much of what some people call unnecessary fluff, like listening to a longer than necessary introduction. We'll cover five things here. The body all pages tag. This is our default tag for the whole project. Then headings and paragraphs. These control most of the default typography on a project. We'll do links, and we'll end by demonstrating how we can use a tag-based style guide to change the world. So, body all pages. We can access this by selecting the body element on any page and going over to our selector field. When we click in there, body all pages. Now, you might see something different on your screen. Two things to check here. One, make sure your computer is on. And two, it's a bit different if your body element has a class applied. If a class is already applied to an element, you could access its tag on the body here. That's body all pages. You can access it from the inheritance dropdown thing on the top right. So, we click it. What does it do? Well, here's what it doesn't do. It doesn't really override anything. Changes we make in body all pages essentially serve as a starting point. And that's an important distinction between tags and classes. Part one, tags are not classes. Part two, tags are tags. Because tags let us set the default styling for entire batches of elements. We're making sweeping changes here that'll be inherited by other stuff in the project. What does that mean? In the body all pages tag, let's choose a typeface. We're just choosing our font from the dropdown. And since this is a blank project, we can add anything in. We can drag in any element from the add panel, carefully censoring top secret future features. And if we look at the font, we can see that the font on this element, this brand new element, is being pulled from the body all pages tag. Now, what if we have a completely built out project with tons of elements? The original version of Iliad made this clear. It's never too late to style an HTML tag, except it said that in Greek and it actually didn't say that at all, but it doesn't mean it's not true. Because with the body element selected, let's go over and access our body all pages tag. Make some changes here, and you'll notice a lot of these things are inheriting these properties. Back to our first example with the blank project, same deal here. The body all pages tag is a great place to set not only the font, but other stuff like the default background color, font size, line height, font color, and the gravitational constant. These defaults can be set on the body all pages tag. Now, suppose we want to override the defaults we just set on some of these elements. That's where we can get more specific. We can still use classes anywhere on anything in our project. But we also have other tags. With that in mind, let's move on to headings, because on the screen it says headings. Now, because we just set a default font a moment ago, dragging in a heading, we're not applying a class or anything, a heading is going to inherit that default font from the tag. Again, at any time, we can check inheritance by clicking the property label here in the style panel. But what if we want to change this? Well, like we already know, we could add a class, and we can just change the font here, which automatically makes a class for us. But here's the problem. We're going to have to add that class to each heading we add. So let's remove this class from our heading for a moment, and let's drag in another heading, another H1. Now, we're using top-level headings here. We're using our H1s, but we could do this for other headings, like all H2s, all H3s. But here's the other option we have. Even before adding a class, we can click into the selector field and go over to all H1 headings. Now, take a look. The font is still being inherited from body all pages. That's expected. But when we change our font, it's updating all our H1s. We know that because of the scientific method, and also because it's happening on the screen right before us. Now, we can go deeper and add a class to some of our H1s to override this even further, but the point here is that tags help us set defaults. We can always override them, but they help us have a great starting point. Let's show that practically. On our body all pages tag, let's say we have our default font set to Tahoma. An H1 heading will by default be Tahoma. But if we set our all H1 headings tag to Playfair, our H1 headings will be Playfair. And if we add a class and we set the font there to Railway, that'll be Railway. That's because elements look up the hierarchy for the first thing they find that has styling information. Put simply, an element like an H1 might have a class, and our H1 is looking to that class for styling information. If it's not there, it looks up and takes its styling cues from the all H1 headings tag, which takes its styling cues from the body all pages tag, which takes its styling cues from GQ. But that's it, that's headings. Let's do the same with paragraphs. Drag in a paragraph, let's place it under the heading, and now we have a paragraph. In fact, with the magic of video editing, we'll snap our fingers, and now we'll have multiple paragraphs. We'll snap our fingers, there they are. With any paragraph selected, we can go into the selector field and access our all paragraphs tag. And a really common thing to do here is to set a more universal line height. Let's use unitless for ours, but this controls the height of each line of text. Again, if you haven't used unitless before, you can type or access the little hyphen from the dropdown. And when that's set, the line height always scales proportionally with the font size, even when you choose bizarrely large font sizes. But designers also use all paragraphs, the all paragraphs tag, to add space between paragraphs. This really helps us group things together naturally. Of course, line height helps us so things don't bleed together from line to line. And bottom margin here helps us make sure each paragraph is visually grouped and distinct from one another. That's the all paragraphs tag. What about links? Well, same deal here. Select any link. This is just a hyperlink we're going to add in the text inside this paragraph, and we'll link it to any URL we want. When we do, suddenly we're confronted with the classic blue underline. Let's say we want to change that. With the link selected, let's go over to our selector field and style all links. Now, we're going to do something common here. We'll change our default link color to not blue, but notice something else. Some of the changes we make can end up affecting all elements that are based on links, like link blocks or buttons that are based on links. And that's a great point to make with some of these tags. They're really helpful for setting defaults, but they can make sweeping changes if you're not tracking exactly what kinds of elements use these tags. So always do an inspection after making tag changes to make sure your design isn't unexpectedly hideous. But that's links. What about a tag-based style guide? Well, one thing that can be enormously helpful is to use this sort of style guide, and we've included a link to this, which you can literally copy and paste right into any project. And what this does, the style guide, is it unlocks all the tags by default. You can select any of these elements and go up without adding a class and access that tag's styling. This is a great way to set project defaults when you're early on in the design process. Now, a lot of people, though, only use this kind of page. They only use this as a reference. So we can build out our project. We can design the whole thing without setting defaults first. This just becomes a straightforward way to access our tags. And if we don't want the page to show up on Google or other search engines, we can just add a password to the page itself. But that's it. Now, one thing to note before we review, tags are extremely critical when styling rich text in Webflow. So if you haven't already, go check out Rich Text on Webflow University, which covers how we can leverage tags to both create consistent designs and make small electroluminescent particles hover completely on their own. So, tags, do we need them? No. Do they help? Yes. We have our most common top-level tag, the body all pages tag, which lets us set things like the default project typography or the background color. We have our headings tags, setting defaults for H1s, H2s, H3s. We have all paragraphs and all links. And we even have the option of creating or pasting in a tag-based style guide, all the defaults accessible from a single page. But what do tags actually do? Well, once you've gotten familiar with classes and all the power you can gain and the time you can save, tags become even more empowering because they cut out so much of what some people might refer to as unnecessary fluff, like listening to a longer than necessary ending to a lesson which tags